Hello.
Oh, hi, is this Kriegel?
Yes, of course, yeah. Hello.
Hey, this is Levi calling from Sticks for Stones in Brisbane, Australia. How are you, my friend?
Well, all right, yeah. All right. Thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, that's the way. Man, I gotta say, I've only been listening to you guys for the last 3 months or so, but ever since I found out about your album Origins, you've been pretty much my favorite band since then. I've been listening to that album every day, and I've gotten into your older stuff as well. So I just want to say it's an absolute awesome album. I'm looking forward to the Australian tour that's coming up next year. Are you excited about coming down under again?
Sure, of course we are, yeah. I mean, it's been way too long since we've been to Australia, and
yeah.
We've been waiting, and I'm definitely looking forward to finally coming back.
Yeah, I think you came about 2 years ago. I missed that one because I didn't know about you guys back then, but did you get a good reception last time you were here?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was, Australia has been treating us very, very well, and it has been our first time to play in Australia back then. I think it's probably even 3 years ago or something. I'm not sure anymore. But yeah, it's been awesome. So yeah, we're really looking forward to finally coming back.
Yeah, and for people reading or listening to the interview now, you guys are actually based in Switzerland, and just wondering how different is the metal scene in Switzerland compared to Australia? Is it, you know, stylistically, I think the bands are, you know, playing a different type of metal, but is there, you know, big crowds and stuff over there?
Sure, yeah. I mean, honestly, I wouldn't know much about Australian metal scenes. I know a couple of Australian bands, but, you know, like, I've just played a couple of shows there.
Yeah.
But to be honest, it's pretty much the same in Switzerland because, like, they're on tour all the time, so they're actually not exactly part of the Swiss metal scene since years. So, but, you know, if it comes to playing shows, honestly, it's actually pretty much the same, I would say.
Okay, yeah.
It feels the same, but then again, to be honest, that's pretty much what it feels like anywhere on the globe. There have been like two places on this planet where it really felt different to play shows, which has been like Japan and India, and anywhere else in the world, like even South Africa, whatever. If it comes down to the concert, it feels like metalheads or metalheads. It doesn't matter where or what culture they're from or whatever. And I'd say, you know, like, this is also like a pretty beautiful thing, actually, because it shows how much music is actually able to unite people. And this is something pretty awesome to observe all around the globe.
Yeah. What I really like about your band is not only do you play heavy metal, but you also do the traditional Celtic music as well. You're playing, you know, bagpipes and violins and hurdy-gurdies. I'm just wondering, what came first for you? Was it the Celtic music or was it the heavy metal?
I think I could never decide.
Yeah.
To be honest. I mean, I pretty much grew up with both. And
yeah.
Both is like kind of my music. This is the music I play since, I don't know, forever, and the music I love, and that's honestly also the reason why I formed Lazy back in the day, because I just wanted to kind of combine my two musical passions. So I don't think I could ever decide.
Yeah, for sure. No, I definitely love it. Now, you're coming to Australia. I just had a few friends ask me. They wanted to know if you're also planning on coming to New Zealand as well. Is there any plans on New Zealand?
I'd fucking love to, honestly. And I think I'm speaking for all of us, but then again, you know, we're not doing the booking. And, you know, like, so far we didn't have the opportunity to come there, and there's nothing booked and like for, you know, the near future or something. But, you know, we definitely would love to go and play in these.
Yeah, no, that'd be great, and I'll let the people know that you're definitely thinking about it. Now, one of the characteristics in some of your songs is, especially the older songs, you actually sing in ancient Ghoulish, the language, and I'm just wondering, how common is that language in Switzerland? Do many people still speak it?
First of all, I don't think it has anything to do with the age of our albums. I mean, to basically, our songs are in English, but, you know, like, since we are a Swiss band, and, like conceptually, lyrically, Helvetii is about, like, Celtic history and Celtic culture.
Yeah.
But the use of the Gaulish language, to me, is like, more, like, let's say, artistic work or something like that. It's basically about to give the narration of history that we do in our songs, to give that some, you know, some flesh and blood and breathe some life in it. It's more about to create an atmosphere. But most of our songs are in English, and it has been like that from day one. But to answer your actual question, it's a dead language. It's like ancient Latin or ancient Greek. So it's died out in the early Middle Ages. So there's no one speaking it, actually. I mean, you know, like, there's... well, it's basically, if it comes to lyrics, but especially, of course, if it comes to the use of the Gaulish language, it's just a shitload of scientific works, and I'm usually working together with, like, a couple of different universities all over Europe. Yeah, if it comes to the use of the Gaulish language, because, as I said, it is a dead language, and you can't exactly learn it. It's more that you can scientifically reconstruct. So you can't exactly say that you speak this language or something like that. I mean, there's definitely no one in Switzerland, like, that, you know, it's just not spoken anymore since, like, around 1,600 years or something like that. But then again, like, in the Swiss language, there's still, like, a lot of Gaulish words that we use.
Yeah.
But, you know, the whole grammar is, like, Germanic, and like in Swiss language. But there's just, like, you know, words that are still Gaulish or of Gaulish origin.
Yeah, no, it's very fascinating stuff. I think I'm definitely going to have to get out there and read some more about Celtic history, because just after getting into your band, it's kind of made me curious about all that kind of culture. And
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. What I love about your film clips, too, is most of your film clips, you're out in the forest playing guitar and playing, you know, heavy metal, and it looks like a lot of fun. But do you think, you know, playing out in the forest, you know, that's part of the music as well? Is it something that inspires you to write the music the way you do?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Honestly, that's actually not something that we ever really thought about very much. You know, like, nearly all the video clips we ever shot were like, very simple. I mean, most of the time there's not like, kind of a storyline with you know, with actors and lots of things like that. I mean, usually it's just like the band playing. So we keep our video clips very simple.
Mm-hmm.
And usually what we think is basically, let's just, like, take some beautiful pictures of beautiful places, but it's kind of an intuitional decision or something like that, and there's no meaning to it or something. But it's, you know, it's probably, we just, you know, love those places, and, you know, if, I mean, in our spare time, which unfortunately there is not much of it, but you know, lots of us go up in the mountains and climbing, or just, you know, go wandering alone in the mountains or stuff like that, if we do have spare times between tours and stuff like that. So it's probably just like an intuitional thing that just basically happened like that. It was never, you know, there's no deeper thought behind it or something like that.
Okay. Well, it's awesome nonetheless. Now, when you're coming down, you're actually going to be doing a whole two-hour set list, which is pretty long. What can we expect from the set list? And are you going to do any songs off the Evocation album? Because that's a lot of the more acoustic sort of stuff.
Definitely, yeah. We just recently premiered that, what we call An Evening with Helvetii, comprising this two-hour set and stuff like that. And we're actually still developing it. But yeah, it's just something we tried out, and something we think is nice and is fun to do as well. It basically consists of like a, you know, well, as you said, a quite extended set list that pretty much covers or goes through or complete discography.
Yeah.
And of course, that also includes songs from Evocation, from our acoustic album. Last couple of shows we, or like the last tour we did that, we did only just, you know, play those Evocation songs, but we actually really changed the stage set up, and we had like a real fully acoustic session, like also like with jamming and everything.
Yeah, awesome. What can we expect from you guys in the future? Is there any more albums or live albums or DVDs planned coming out?
Of course, yeah. I mean, what's in store for next year is another album, which I'm working on right now, actually, and for the next couple of months, which will be the second part of Evocation. So the second part of the acoustic concept. We're planning to go to the studio next summer somewhere. So yeah, that's definitely on the list. Looking forward to that a lot, to be honest. And well, DVDs, yeah, that's also a topic that has been on our minds for a long time. But, you know, so far we just never really had the opportunity to do it because we thought we, if we ever going to release a DVD, it shall be just like, you know, whatever, you know, a live DVD with a complete live show or whatever, because we think that's kind of weird to release something like in the age of YouTube and all that. So, but we wanted to make it something like pretty extended that, you know, with, you know, complete festival shows, complete live shows from different continents, and a lot of tour reports from different continents, and shitloads of behind the scenes stuff, and so on. Like, so if we gonna do something like that, which actually is on our mind still, and we still actually would like to do something like that, but if we will, it shall be something like pretty extended.
Yeah, for sure, man. I'm definitely looking forward to those releases, and I'll be up the front row at your tour next year anyway, so I'll be taking photos for the website, so
very good.
Send your full copy if you'd like.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Yeah, no worries, man. Well, I'll see you at the show. Have a good one, man.
You too. Thank you.
Okay, bye. Bye.